starting for the North American division. And back in the early 80s, when we were really starting to display for the North American division, not just local conferences, Eleanor Middag was a youth director for the NAD. And Elder Middag was preaching in a church one day, and they were in the ante room having prayer with the head elder and whatnot, waiting for the announcements to go over, to go online, to go on the platform. And he started telling them about the historian ministry and collecting the history of Pathfinders. And after he spoke to them about it, the pastor reached into the trash can, picked out this banner and said, "Oh, you mean stuff like this?" It would have been in the trash the following day, well, Monday, when the trash went. I've added the pins that are up there, but everything else was on that banner being tossed. And we collect anything SDA history, particularly youth ministry and Pathfinders. So it's important. I don't care if it's been in a trash can.
It's true.
But, yeah.
So these are the exact ones?
That is it. Yeah.
Wow.
It was in a trash can. Because, you know, missionary volunteers is something way back when, and they didn't want it, so they're throwing it away. But our prayer is that people will realize how important the old stuff is to the museum, not to you personally, not to your club personally, maybe, but to the museum.
To the museum.
And get it to the North American division so we can share it. Camperies and things. This is just a tiny little display.
Why is it, so which state is that?
What state?
Uh-huh.
I call it my New Jersey banner. Does
New
that
Jersey
tell you
banner.
Anything?
And about the uniform?
That uniform is the old uniform that was worn actually by my sister, Lieber. She died in 1970, so it's a very special one to me. But it shows.
Okay. Ruben,
the MV,
at 29 over here,
and it was an MV uniform then. Originally, and when Pathfinders started wearing uniforms in the 40s and the 1940s, then they chose the same uniform. And then later,
29 and 34.
In 1957, it became two-piece, the green skirt and the green top. So through the years, it's changed.
So initially, it was one full?
One dress. It was a dress originally.
So which year was that? Was she, did she wear that?
This actually was worn by two people. Somebody wore it before her. But this would have been in the 40s and 50s and up till 57 when they changed the uniform.
Wow, now to this one.
Well, no, this is Master Guy.
Oh, this is Master Guy.
That wasn't. That was a regular Pathfinder and staff. All the ladies wore.
Oh, the ladies wore that.
Yeah. And the uniform over here belonged to Jerry Patzer. Elder Patzer was the North Pacific Division.
Oh, Jerry Patzer.
Union Youth Director at one time. He's passed away. And that's, you know, people pass stuff on to us and we're thrilled.
And the one above it?
I made the vest so that we could have them when Arnold and I are out and about. We needed a pocket to put our cards or whatever, mm-hmm. and so I made vests to put the patches. And our policy was don't put a patch on unless you've been to the camperee.
Mm-hmm.
So we have camperees from Brazil, from all over, Union camperees, and different places on here.
Yep. Parents?
Wow.
This is Brazil.
Take a look at the person
that's the third South American division
there
camperee.
Go. They say, God loves you.
This is in Bahia.
There you go. Parents.
Brazil for a camperee in 1999.
Any from Africa there?
No. You know, we were invited to come to the Africa one way back when, and then they called us and said, you know, we've decided, they made changes, new leaders or whatever, and they decided we can't afford to fly you there. And afterwards, they talked and said, oh, we're so sorry we didn't.
There you go.
We need to make it to Africa too, so that
we're totally, Arnold and I were totally self-supporting, and so, you know, we couldn't afford to fly all those places ourselves.
True. So that's how the many places you've gone.
Yep.
I see Colorado.
The first big one was
Colorado.
85 in Colorado.
Wow.
But there's so many more that Union camperees and conference camperees.
So did you do all this, the collection? I know Chosen. We were in Chosen.
That's your the question, kind of, did I do what?
Did you do all this collection?
Oh yeah, it's ours. What we do when we go to the International Gallery is we take empty cases with a little sign. Would you like your pin? Here. And these have all been given to us for the museum.
Oh, well, where is the museum?
Well, it's a traveling museum for the North American Division. It's called Historian Ministry.
Historian Ministry.
And we travel to Union Conference Division Camporees in the North American Division and display because we think it's really important our young people know the history of how God is led.
True.
And so we love to tell stories and that type of thing. Did you notice the flag over here? I don't know the exact date.
All right, how are we doing, monitors? Yeah? You went one by one. All right, if you're still not connected, can you raise your hand, monitor? Still not connected, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 6. All right.
How is
it? Try it again.
See.
All right, 85, you're having fun over there.
The flag that I was mentioning, all done by hand.
You
can buy the flag itself, but all this is done by hand.
By hand?
We are seeing already.
Wow.
To make it. It was before they made flags.
That's before the flags.
That you could buy like we can now.
How many of you are not connected?
Wow, thank you so much for the ministry.
You're welcome. Listen,
what's your name again?
Pardon me?
Your name again?
Oh, Dixie Plata.
Dixie Plata.
Historian for the North American Division.
Perfect.
My husband and I have been doing that since the early 80s.
Since the 80s?
Yeah.
It's a blessing
and
to meet
sharing.
You.
It's a the blessing. First thing I collected was when I was a kid, so, you know.
Which is the first one you collected?
First thing?
Which one is the very first one you collected?
You know, I have to stop and think because I collected two things that year, and I have to remember, did I go to summer camp at Camp Mivin in Hayden Lake, Idaho, and then go with my grandparents to Loma Linda? But anyway, a songbook in Loma Linda. It was a junior youth congress that was held in the old, what do they call those places, outdoor arena where mm-hmm. Ellen White had spoken.
Uh-huh.
Gave me goosebumps to sit there because I knew the history.
Yeah.
And Elder Hancock, John Hancock, signed my program. So I have that in the songbook. And the second thing was at summer camp, I had 35 cents to spend on anything I wanted. You know, that was a lot of money for kids in those days. At least it was for our family. Nobody had money. Like, kids now have a $10 bill. And wow, you know.
True.
But I went in the store every day with my unit from our cabin, and I finally decided, and I bought a bar of soap with a Pathfinder emblem on it. And I still have it.
Wow.
It's part of the display, but I don't have it.
Wow. I have been to the LNG White Estate in Michigan.
Oh, yes.
It's just beautiful together, and yeah. You know.
Yeah, very interesting. The GC, the General Conference in
yeah.
Maryland, have a wonderful display.
I haven't been. I think that's the place
yeah,
I need to go.
It's worth going. It's wonderful.
Maryland. Okay.
Yeah, all these pins were given to us. Just make a little pen. And we have youth directors that will send us the pins
the
of their
pins.
Conference made and stuff because they know we'll display it. And the kids love to come. There's our pin, you know.
Yeah.
So. And the reason
they are beautiful.
I brought display pins is because there's so many young people here and they love to look at them.
There's so many different pins. With a sash, a wrap of fender sash. It was a very fast call.
So, nickname, you relog in. So, that means that's one of them.
That's my head. That's my head.
B U A 93. You have that hat, relog in. And your nickname is your team. Okay? So, 12, B U 62. That also. 11, VU, 42, that is log in. 12,
New York.